salvation of Christ. With this vibrant call, I would like to extend a warm welcome and delight morning to Reverend Mother Antonamma, Superior General and Ex Officio Moderator of the Chapter, Reverend Sister Mary Paul Teresa, Provincial Superior and President of the Chapter, and all dear capitulars of CSSA Guntur Province. At the threshold of this morning, our hearts bring me joy and gratitude for the infallible deeds that God has done in our province and the fascinating blessings He has stored for us for the days ahead in the chapter. Dear sisters, God began His intricate work from past 5 chapters in our province and today opened a new way through the 6th chapter to be a remarkable one. A chapter is a milestone calling each of us to celebrate the mark of God's mighty hand. Dear sisters, I take this prestigious opportunity to extend a warm welcome to you all to take part in this celebration, to sing the hymn of thanksgiving to the Lord. So let our hearts swell with celebration and jubilation as we commence this sacred spiritual moment of 6th Provincial Chapter of Guntur Province by taking the badge. I request Mother Antonamma and Sister Mary Paul Teresa to take the badge for each other. Mother Antonamma and Sister Paul Teresa to pin the badge to all the assembled members of PC6, echoing the love and hospitality.
Welcome to this divine chapter.
Once again, hearty welcome dear practitioners to this vibrant home, where together we will create a future at home. And gave me peace so to our mother congregation. Therefore, today as a legend, crowned as a servant of God in the Holy Church, and her powerful intercession is accompaniment in all the details of our prayers. By giving salute to God Almighty for making our mother as a universal mother, and her blessings in the field of our province administration and governance, as we release this balloon into the space, I request our provincial superiors, Sister Teresa, to release the balloon as a joyful melody of fruitful administration.
Thank you. to adorn our Amma with a garland, and all of you to honor her with a floral petals, and take a light from her, which is placed at the station, and come back to your place, carrying with you the essence of her spirit into the chapter hall.
Let this flame symbolize the illumination of every idea, discussion, and decision we undertake during this chapter.
Symbolizing our commitment to the living by the principles and values they embody. As the procession progresses, the provincial team members carry the logo and themes of our previous and present chapters, signifying the continuity of our spiritual journey.
and the wisdom gleaned from the past experiences. And finally, the sisters carrying the lighted candles bring forth the illumination of knowledge, wisdom, and divine grace. Next follows the order and proceed to the chapter hall.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 10, verses 10 and 11. I stayed on the mountain 40 days and 40 nights, as I had done the first time. And once again the Lord listened to me. The Lord was unwilling to destroy you. The Lord said to me, "Get up, go on your journey at the head of the people, that they may go in and occupy the land that I swore to their ancestors to give them." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Mother. The Code of Canon Law reminds us that the constitutions provide the constitutive or essential norms that reflect the sacred patrimony of the institute, Canon 578. True to this, our promised journey can be civilized, refined, and cultured in broadest sense for wholeness, fullness, and fruitfulness only by the norms of our CSSA family. Let us esteem this central law for missionary life. As I request Reverend Sister Mary Paul Teresa, the president of the chapter, to read the constitution, article number 101, and place it in front of Mother Nanama and pay reverence to the portrait of Mother Nanama with a garland.
The provincial chapter is a collegial gathering of representatives of all the sisters of a province, and it exercises the highest extraordinary authority in the province according to the proper law. The principal functions are to protect patrimony, to review the religious life, to foster renewal, to elect provincial superior and councillors, to issue norms as per directives of general chapter, to evaluate the province, and to deal with matters of great importance.
Dear sisters, I request all of you kindly be seated. The actualization of the BC6 is just a few minutes from now. A ripple of excitement goes around the room as we begin the session. The 6 months of meticulous preparations has come to climax with this 6th provincial chapter. Let's know the significance of number 6 in the Bible scriptures. The Yahweh created the man on the 6th day and completed the entire creation within 6 days. The Spirit of Yahweh rested on Moses and Joshua for 6 days on Mount Sinai. The angel Gabriel appeared to Mary to reveal that nothing is impossible with God, when her cousin Elizabeth was in her 6th month of pregnancy. The glory of Jesus is revealed by turning 6 jars of water into wine. Hence, the number of 6 has a great importance in the scriptures. As we are here to embrace this solemn task, as we believe God's rhythm in our journey, let's go forth for the mission which is joyful. Let's go forth for the mission which is fruitful. Let's go forth for the mission which is ultimately destined. As we are in our walk towards this worthy journey of grace-filled and spirit-filled event, let us seek the blessings of God through opening prayer. I humbly call upon Sister Bala Kalaveri to lead us into prayer.
Hold my heart, burn with love in
praise to you. We thank you for your heart transforming and life changing power in the church. As Mary, our mother, and apostles felt your presence, may your presence be felt in this place, leading us to make decisions that align with your will, acknowledging that you are the source of all wisdom and understanding. We invite your divine direction as we navigate the matters at hand. May your counsel and fortitude flow through us, enabling us to find innovative solutions and make sound decisions. May your knowledge and piety fill our hearts, fostering an atmosphere of respect and understanding. May the fear of the Lord steer our discussions, helping us to prioritize and address matters effectively. Bless everyone present here with unity and productivity. Facilitate us to listen attentively, speak clearly, and understand solicitously, to communicate with respect and kindness, building bridges of connection. We ask this in your holy name, O Lord.
Amen.
Mary, our mother.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Anna of Patroness.
Pray for us.
Mother Nani, mother servant of God, our beloved foundress.
Intercede for us.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
To the ceremony of the lighting of the lamp, a symbolic representation of the illumination brought forth by the dedication and sacrifice of those who have served our province. Now let's recall our journey of the province from its inception to till date, and how wonderfully God led us to be icons of His mission. As we recall the iconic figures of our history, symbolizing the continuity of leadership and the legacy of our service upheld by our previous leaders. First week of the land. I invite Reverend Mother Anthurama to lead the first week of the land. Representing all the superior generals of our CSSA who paved the path to their tireless services and unwavering dedication to our society. Second week of the land, I invite Reverend Sister Mary Angelina, the first regional superior of Guntur region, to lead the second week of the land. Representing all the regional superiors of Guntur region who had sown seeds for its fruitful mission initiation. Third week of the land, I invite Reverend Sister Fatima Ignatius, the first provincial superior of Guntur province, to lead the third week of the land, representing all the capitulars of First Provincial Chapter and her dedicated team members who challenged and nurtured our roots. Fourth week of the land, I invite Reverend Sister Vagna Mary, the team member of 2nd Provincial Chapter of our province, to lead the 4th week of the land, representing all the capitulars of 2nd Provincial Chapter and the devoted team members of this term. Fifth week of the land, I invite Reverend Sister Ratna Mary, the 2nd Provincial Superior of Guntur province, to lead the fifth week of the Lamp, representing all the capitulars of third provincial chapter and her dedicated team members. Sixth week of the Lamp, I invite Reverend Sister Maria Suja, the team member of 4th Provincial Chapter, to lead the sixth week of the Lamp, representing all the capitulars of 4th Provincial Chapter and the Steadfast team members. Seventh week of the Lamp, I invite Reverend Sister Mary Paul Teresa, the third provincial superior of Guntur province, to lead the final week of the Lamp, representing all the capitulars of 5th and 6th provincial chapters and her passionate team members. Now I request you, dear sisters, to stand up and receive the light of Christ by stretching out our hands. Now I also invite you for the chapter prayer from page number 75 of the chapter manual. Page number 75 from the chapter manual. Let's together pray.
Wisdom and unwavering commitment to our shared mission serve as a guiding light for all of us. We are deeply grateful for the opportunity to benefit from your counsel and experience as we navigate the path ahead. With heartfelt love, once again, I am delighted and honored to welcome our dear Reverend Mother Antonamma onto the dais with your sapling. I invite Sister Sauchanya Kumari, the first secretary of the province, to welcome our mother with a beautiful sapling. With deepest warmth and admiration, my heart pays a cheerful welcome to our dear Reverend Sister Mary Paul Teresa, the Provincial Superior of Guntur Province. As the President of the Chapter, dear sister, your dedicated leadership, countless sacrifices, visionary insight to our province have been a source of strength and inspiration to all of us. You shot the decisions in one word, which is for sure a road of prosperity and development. Hence, may I now invite sister to come on to the dais. I invite Sister Mary Roshini, the second secretary of the province, to welcome our dear sister with a sapling. Of the way, but the goodness of a person spreads in all directions. Amidst us, we have such an inspiring personality who has spread her goodness in all the directions of our CSSN family, especially in our province. She is none other than Reverend Sister Fatima Ignatius. Her vibrant spirituality, steady on deep faith, courage of convictions, love for the province, and determined efforts are ever recorded in the memory of our CSSA Guntur province. It's my honored pleasure to welcome you, dear sister, onto the dais as the moderator of the day. May I now invite Sister Mary Rajika, the third secretary of the province, to welcome our dear sister with a sapling. May these saplings offered mark the beginning of new chapter filled with growth, prosperity and harmony under the counsel of ex officio moderator, the president of the chapter and the moderator of the day. Dear capitulars, every provincial chapter is a new Pentecost. The spirit manifests itself anew to its members to be united, communitarian and prayerful for the mission with great fraternity and sisterhood beyond boundaries. Let's responsibly respond to the whisperings of the Spirit as the future of the province rests upon our shoulders. Finally, a big thanks to all of you, dear mother and sisters, for your patience and kind cooperation throughout the proceedings. May I now request Reverend Sister Fatima Ignatius, the moderator of the day, to continue further proceedings of protocol session. Thank you one and all.
Thank you, sister. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His love endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good, for His love endures forever. Roll call by Sister Fatima Ignatius, Reverend Mother Antonamma P.
Present, sister.
Sister Mary Paul Teresa.
Yes, sister.
Sister James Robert.
Yes, sister.
Sister Mary Angelina.
Yes, sister.
Sister Fatima Ignatius, myself. Sister Luke Ratnam, A.
Yes, sister.
Sister Cecily Thomas, N.
Yes.
Sister Bethel Mary Y.
Yes, sister.
Sister Maria Sujia, K.
Yes,
sister Nima Mary, K.
Yes, sister.
Sister Ratna Mary, R.
Yes, sister.
Sister Lily Grace, G.
Yes, sister.
Sister Mama Mary Josephine, M.
Yes,
Sister Paranda Teresa K.
Yes, sister.
Sister Maridani M.
Yes,
sister. Sister Sanae Silva Ida.
Yes, sister.
Sister Gish Mary Provincial Chapter.
Province and the presidents of the 6th provincial chapter hereby declare that the 6th provincial chapter of Guntur province is open on 19th May 2024 at 9:20 a.m. Let God be praised. Let's start.
All the matters that produce